Hello students, in previous lecture we have already taken information about the short run supply curve and the long run supply curve. All of you know the short run supply curve, it is the part of the marginal cost curve which is from above the average cost curve, and long run supply curve, it is a part of the long run marginal cost curve which is from above the long run average cost curve. Students, today we are going to take more information for the market supply curve. Then what is the market supply curve? The market supply curve means which shows the output levels of the curves in the market produce in the aggregator corresponding different values of the market price. Means here the market supply curve which refers to the total supply of the pearls in the market at the market price. Suppose there are the two pearls in the market, means the pearl of one and pearl of two. Suppose there are the two pearls in the market, pearl of one and the pearl of two. Then market supply is equal to the supply of pearl one plus the supply of pearl two. See here, if there are the two pearls in the market, pearl one and pearl two, then the market supply is the supply of the pearl one and the supply of the pearl two. Means the market supply curve which is obtained by the summation, horizontal summation of the individual supply curve of the pearls which is existing in the market. Students, we will explain it with the help of an example and a diagram.
here if the verb 1 supplies 2-1 level of the output at P1 price, means the verb 1 will not undertake the production if price is below the P1. See here, the verb 1 supplies the Q1 level of the output at P1 price. Means here, the verb 1 will not undertake the production if the price is below than the P1. Why? Because here the production, cost of the production is more than the profit, and it is not desirable to the firm. Suppose if P1, see here what I say, if P1 is 10 rupees, then supply of the firm 1, see here S1 is the supply of the firm 1 equal to, if the P is, means the price is less than the 10 rupees, then quantity supplied from the firm 1 is 0. Why? Because here the price is less than the 10. And suppose if the price is greater than the 10, then quantity supplied from the firm 1 is P, means the price minus 10 rupees. This is the first equation. Similarly, firm 2 will not undertake the production Q2 if the price is equal or above the P2. See here, the firm 2 will not undertake the production if the price is equal or price is above the P2. See here, suppose if the P2 is 15 rupees, then the supply of firm 2 is equal to, means if the price of commodity is less than the 15 rupees, then quantity supply of the firm 2 is 0. Why? Because here the price is less than the 15. And suppose if the price is equal to the 15, then quantity supplied of the firm 2 is equal to P minus 15, and this is the second equation. So here the both firms means firm 1 and firm 2 choose not to produce if price is below P1. See here, the both firms choose not to produce if price is below P1. Here the firm 1 undertakes the positive production or positive dollar of the output at Q1 and P1 price, and firm 2 undertakes the positive level of the output or positive production at Q2 and the P2 prices. So here the market will be supplied So here we will explain. See here, A means the diagram A shows the supply curve of the firmly. See here, the A diagram shows the supply curve S1, it is the supply curve of the firmly. B, which shows the supply curve of the firmly. Thank you.